kings is everywhere, fathers is never there. Where they clap chrome, the backbone of the eastern hemisphere. You shop on Rodeo Drive, we shop on Fulton Air. You ride in limousines, we ride in dollar vans. Your favorite rapper's alive, our favorite rapper died. If you an outcast, you get cast out and cast aside. If you put a 9-year-old on blast.
Put your money where your mouth is. Back to basics, Los Angeles. Make some noise, y'all. Yeah! I've got a crazy bat about to pop off. First off, I'd like to shout out Flip Top Battle League all the way in the Philippines. Man, always been killing it, supporting King of the Dot, and likewise. So make some noise for Flip Top, y'all. Yeah! Jumping into the battle. Battle to my right, introduce yourself.
West up, Muda down, test us, choose a style, the best, don't fool around. Fredo Algebra, Union City, California, great Muda, let's go. Let's go.
Yeah. Coming all the way from the Philippines, battler to my left, introduce yourself.
Yo, Enigma, Filipinas, shoutouts, Flip Top, Uprising, L Boys, all that good shit, all my loved ones back home. Yo, I'd like to say, man, believe it or not, it's my first time in the States, so I'm just glad to hear you.
Toss. It is on Enigma. Please hold it down and show love. This dude literally traveled across the world for this exact moment. So let's go.
Let's go.
Osta. Ayos.
Yeah. Woo.
Yo. You know how I know you're not a real Filipino? You're not just a fat American. You're also a fucking fat Filipino. For real though. Fuck your fob-hating upbringing. You should get stomped straight to oblivion for thinking you're some hard Asian mud-slinging R-race from its rough English. If only you would partake of enough wisdom, you would not save such opinions, because your scarred neighbors was no different from your mom and pops' choppy language when they first lived here. Your large frame that's equipped with a large brain must be a hindrance in being at least half-heartedly thankful you were given a better starting place for you to finish. It would be smart changing that dull vision if you act like a green card ain't a fucking privilege, especially when American really means y'all were part alien to begin with. Of starvation, you have no inkling. You weren't farm-raised, so what's up with this big spin? No walk of fame on that one strip, but he'll be stargazing when I jump kick him. Teeth will part ways. Blood trickling down his shock face and slumped lips, looking like Art Blakey when he's drug tripping. So try and diss real Filipino shit. You don't know what survival really means. Never dug a hole to shit in the jungle and wipe your ass with a leaf. You got to... couldn't improvise everything that you would need from a tree. You haven't opened a bottle cap with your motherfucking teeth. You'd probably rip your hair out if you lost electricity for a week. You are what you eat and all your shit weak. You couldn't even develop immunity to diseases. You couldn't cook or stomach an adobo made from janitor fish or even fucking zombie pieces. Never hustled on the streets, scuffle with police, get busted just for weed. You don't know what survival really means. I dare to try drunk and high driving a motorcycle in the Philippines, bitch. Yeah, y'all got drive-bys. Back home, we don't even need guns. Every day you can die right when any vehicle drives by. So get it straight. So get it straight, Holmes. It's peso. Not peso. Your name should be Predo and not Fredo. If you ever came home, I'd introduce you to real Predos to make you feel safe, yo, but you would still be a Fredo. Fuck Fredo and fuck J-Bro. But J-Bro helped me with my visa and married a Filipina, so now he's cool based on my say-so. J-Bro, just playing, bro. Yo, you're in quite a predicament. For all those years of trying to fit in with your rhyming style considered slightly more interesting because it doesn't remind them of flip shit, so they're surprised by your pigment, acting like you've got no pride in your kinsmen. You've picked your side. You might as well drop the hyphenated description. Then Flip Top goes wild on the internet and all of a sudden he's dying to visit, prying for riches on top of a hotel. Plus I have to buy him a ticket as if we owe you some type of recognition when you, out of all these sly little bitches who have never provided assistance, should know better than to try and swipe a slice of the pie from our kitchen. But I guess when was sired by an immigrant, have no diet restrictions, and live life like the sky's the limit, and hasn't had the tiniest glimpse of what it's like to persist in the dire conditions of the islands you relinquished, let alone rise from the trenches and build an empire from the pillage. Then you grow up to be an oversized, inconsiderate, conniving, insipid, slimy, opportunistic, bright politician looking ass motherfucking dipshit. Anatomical design is inconsistent. You're actually the giant of midgets. Oh. And you got a digestive system that makes you fart silent but liquid. You don't know back home shit, because your American eyes can't envision things outside the world that you're living in. I'm not even nationalistic, yet I know both local and American shit, not because I'm Americanized, because of the world I'm a citizen. So fuck whatever you're speaking. I don't need you to give me a reason to rip you to pieces. Shit, even the embassy in Manila didn't put a check on business or leisure, since they knew I'd represent all of our people who really killed for a visa. Kaintang e baktang, you know?
King of the Dots giving me twat. Instead, y'all put two Filipinos versus each other. Y'all thinking that's hot? Look at everybody on the crowd. Hating, tripping. Everybody flipping their tops. It's all right, though. Because this shit had me thinking a lot. Like, this matchup might make it to one of them hip-hop history docs, like my own people on island hating on me. Instead of giving me props, they digging my plot, calling me Balik Bayan. Okay, now I'm finna give them that box. Yo, listen, dog, don't play with me. Hoes, I make them obey the whole bay, it seems, feed me whole grapes, and their homeboys donate they weed. I'm throwing a party, yay, no more no-name MCs. And for those days, I have no vacancy, and some of my past matchups seem so lame to me. And since KOTD is our domain host, Maitre D, we at the House of Gods, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Shit's gonna be like a home game for me. I'm upset, damn. I understand that you're flip-top, but here I'm the top flip. Give me cred, fam. Soon as your passport got that fresh stamp, it was Hulkamania when the leg land. This matchup bigger than Thriller in Manila. It's been said, damn. I said, this matchup bigger than Thriller in Manila, homie. Let's dance. No. Because after the right cross hit you, and then that left lift, it's trash over. Last Bola versus Head Ice, you're going to see another dead man on the red cam. How the lamest MC think he had a game to test me? How you gonna teach all these people when you say all your statements messy and you can't even spell your name correctly? Question, are you daring or bluffing? For instance, let's take something generic in substance like what we wearing in public, compare it, terrible. This shit's embarrassing, cousin. Those are rare. What are those, Air Harriet Tubmans? Yo. You supposed to be scary or something? Acting all militant for hip hop with your fist up when you on the scene. Dirty ass, desert storm, camouflage on all your jeans. If I wrote an autobiography using your bars and schemes, I'd probably call that shit 50 Shades of Army Green. Oh. You have hair like a bitch. And if you start bitching, I'ma ask you to grab a tampon. Cause nobody in their right mind is in here to see you chat your rap songs with tantrums pants on. Fuck out of my face.
Yo, storing weight is an enormous waste, and sort of strange if you're poor in taste. If a four-bar multi-joke that ends with a simile is all he chases, then I can't support your statements. If you insist that shit is more than basic, then you're fucking with yourself, and that's an orgy, ain't it? I mean, you put the four in fornicating. Fuck Fredo Algebra. I don't have to further explore your nature. Even your corny alias is formulaic. See, he referenced the Hoffa punch separately in two battles, and still the punchline in both wouldn't land. So I don't even need algebra and proving that you stupid ass couldn't do the math. But what prevents that old Fred Algebra from being one of the West Chapter's best rappers? I mean, he's got vet status, sometimes his pen savage. I guess man's really just lacking that X factor. Get it? That's algebra. So you try to perfect your syllable count, but you don't make your syllables count. Like you've switched them around, using your numbers to solve for letters. No wonder Fredo's algebra couldn't figure shit out. Shit's tragic. He thought he'd make big numbers off hit classics if he called his album Arithmatic. Then they thought they became cooler when they named their crew Great Muda. I don't care if you took that from some wrestler. In Tagalog, that means y'all literally giant-eyed boogers. Great Muda. Y'all some lame putas. If y'all weren't gay, y'all would be straight losers. See, he said in an interview his click picked Great Muda because of his signature move and that y'all represent the green poison mist that he spits at dudes. So since rappers spit and you're a rapper and Great Muda spits poison, yeah, I get it, cool. There's an ocean of creativity and y'all pick to swim in the kiddie pool. It's not original and hardly an inch removed from the physical act of spitting. Dude, y'all might as well have called yourselves the Poison Spitting Crew. Then all of a sudden you made a backronym for Muda. Most unstoppable team around. As if that really was the initial definition y'all had meant to use. That shit is stupid. Is that supposed to get us spooked? How can you be ignorant of us and think that we still all live in Nipa huts when you got more than just Filipino blood? Shit, he evolved from a coconut. He did evolve from a coconut. Check his genetics. Brown, round, dirty husk, euphemizing his chin size and get him to open up and it's all white on the inside. Oh! Yeah. But he doesn't exactly walk and talk Caucasian. He's a cocky Asian, the wigger type. Got whitewashed with low quality paint and a faulty paintbrush. I always knew the States was a melting pot of races, but brown boy wanna be the black, wanna be a white? That's darn amazing. So I discovered that the only reason why you've never thought of coming back to the motherland, you're already fucking fat, but your mom's so fat, your mother's lad. What's up with that? You should get an award for best reluctant over actor. Check him chuckle at his own jokes after in an attempt to cover up his character. Trying hard to pretend he's not trying hard when all your impressions are always directed at the camera. But I do commend that one time you didn't look amateur. When you embraced your whiteness, couldn't guard the wall and couldn't walk any further in Game of Thrones. That was pretty accurate. So besides the acting stuff, I heard he's an environmental fashion buff. Used recyclable material, was inspired by slimy massive jugs. Put out a line, Fredo's algae bros. And the only time your clothes are tight are only because of your body type, and that's all besides the hip hop sizing. If I had a penny for every free hip hop shirt I've taken home since, I'd be so rich. But I don't give a fuck about clothes, bitch. I got my own fits, and y'all are just keeping up with the Joneses. I donate my wardrobe to broke kids and the homeless. The clothes don't make the man, but it will help make you a grown pig. If y'all haven't noticed, he looks exactly like Popo. Shit, you just need a uniform. I'm sure you already got the donuts. So go pretend your clothes are fresh and hope it sells, but it won't make sense, because no amount of thorough threads will ever make you thoroughbred. I ain't gonna teach us.
It's on Fredo, let's go!
Alright. Hey, yo, what up, my Nigma? Yo, I've been moving mountains with my fountain pen. You the type to have long ass hair, right? Cut it all off, and then he fucking grows it out again. Yo, you do shit like that, it makes me think you can ne'er get with me. The flare make you stare vividly at the rare imagery of me breaking down your hair's history, like where to start, what to say. You battled Dirtbag when it was long enough to braid, Step Easy when it was short enough to fade, J-Pro when you had subtle waves, and Alfredo during the ugly phase. Or your hair too, I was talking about your fucking face. Yo, don't let the average Joe fool you. Sure, in the Philippines, your rapid magic show super, but it all melts down from the classic lashings of the acid flow. Muda, and after the brain matter scattered at your Jackie O scoops up, I flip tops. The president gonna need half his dome sutured from the rapid calico of the grassy nose shooter. Yo. Wait a minute, yeah. I'm really confused. This to me seems to be somewhat of a silly dispute, cause you're gonna die either way like Blizzard or Bishop in Juice. We could take it to the lab, I'd still be willing to shoot. I kill the president and leave the blood spilling the booth. I'm John Wilkes in the booth.
Oh,
yo, even Filipinos in this league debated. But why they even hate it? I've been unappreciated by all of my speaking rated natives. I feel like the first round draft pick being traded before I even played it. But could y'all do what I did for this scene that we created? No, you probably go back to your scene and recreate it. Yo. See, I be creative whenever I see your name or need to state it. I see it. Why you spell your shit like any grandma abbreviated? Yo, what I demonstrate's elite. What you saying, hella fake, like when David Blaine levitates on streets. My human right hand activate, probably renovate your teeth. In order to beat you, I have to copy humidity so I can generate some heat. I accelerate beyond these featherweight second-rate MCs with all of those big-ass schemes that decorate your sheets. What is this, legislative week? Your shit sounds like a declaration speech. Yo, and your style is an example of when an MC sounds like a text battle. Yo, after I split his intestines into minuscule sections, all you hear is indigestion. If I didn't get no vision reflection of what Enigma spitting in sessions, I'd get the impression of a GPS system giving directions. Yo, while I'm the West is fresh, co-secret weapon X, the best is kept. Dirtbag served you for 3 rounds straight and still lost because you set up bets. Now I'm here to fucking shake up Flip Top like an Etch-A-Sketch, and I'll let y'all know it's bigger than hip-hop when I dead your prez.
Let's go. Grab three and nigga, give me the dot. Let's go.
Yo. Yo, Fredo. If you're clearly opposed to being brand stamped as some kind of nerd, why would you say lyrical flow in your team backpack cypher verse? How'd you even get votes? That shit was ass crack as far as I'm concerned. Ranked 17 in the polls? Must have had some real G's ransack cyber turf. He was like, here we go with the critical blow. It's like I fed my lyrical flow with miracle grow.
Let's go.
Here we go with the critical blow? I don't even want to ask what that's about. It's like I fed my lyrical flow with miracle grow. I'm insisting to know, were you also flipping the dip in the scroll and was it spiritual though? Putting miracle grow on your lyrical flow means you've admitted it openly. Your skill is artificially honed. You said you were a mix of Thesaurus and Diz, so you're another stereotypical clone. Your shit is exposed. Think your syllables dope with your simpleton prose when you're only as intricately woven as some kid skipping a rope. Getting stuck in the Ground Zero League must have been painful. Compare our records and it's bad enough that I was paid to slave fool. But before this, and among a bunch of other no-name dudes, you had to battle Pariah, Joe Cutter, and you were supposed to battle Manic. God damn it, the organizers must really hate you. Whether or not your wild imagination helps, having said all that fat shit against Reverse Live, you must really hate yourself. I guess we have to accept the fact that you're just too fat to embrace yourself.
Double meaning.
Just too fat to embrace yourself. And here's one of his best quotes against Rowan. He was like, I'm not A-class, DNA, Caustic, or any other fucker that you lost to. So if you're not like the people whom you claim beat Roan, that means you took a loss too. And guess what, you lost too. You did though. Shit, throwing me off and shit.
And
you took a loss too. I've read harder instruction manuals than you. And he's worried I know this, when it's not his turn, observe him real closely. Pacing with such a concerned, nervous emotion like your burger was stolen. I can tell you're a fat boy with chicken legs. And want to get fatter only so you can think of more chicken when you see your legs become thicker chicken legs. Oh, fuck, man. Thicker chicken legs. And yo, shit, man, trying to clown on me when your rounded cheeks amount to greed from devouring pounds of beef and yours the only mouth you feed. Let's see you house MCs. Wake up every day to think about the scene and how it should be. Help out careers regardless of how you actually sound to me. Get the local hip-hop to live out their dreams, and even if I personally never put out CDs, bitch, all of that is what I'm proud to be. So don't even test. Saying I'm not tight just tightens the rope on your neck. My opus has wrecked all sorts of notions and expectations. It's no exaggeration that your own kinfolk have already checked. Even my footnotes, a foot soldier better show some respect. You've been wishing for a vacation, so here goes the arrangement. I got a million folks just waiting for me to put dinner on the table. So this pig gets shown the blade from my scribbled notes. It's paper cut through skin, all folded layers into strips and flown in crates. Even the Muslims will throw me thanks for bringing home the bacon. Worthless bitch. I make people feel smart when my verse proves things and the worldview's fixed. You make people feel smart because you're stupid. Yo, fuck the judges, man. Win or lose, Flip Top 470 million views. It took you 30 plus battles to total a million views. Well, isn't that cute?
Alright, well,
my Enigma.
Yo, just to let y'all know, just to let you know, I'm Filipino as hell. I take ownership for my region. In battles, fools don't call me Japanese, Chinese, Korean, Asian, like it's the same shit, people. We go to school for a reason. I'm knowing back home, me and you, hope the economy rise, but it won't. And sure, some of our people will kill a dog and eat it, only because they'll die if they don't.
Yo, but that's not even the case here, because you're not even poor though, buddy. You're probably actually worth more money. Even though off first sight, your clothes look secondhand because you're in a third world country. Facts. I'm one of the first Pinoys to earth these boys. Under the radar, I let my words destroy. Verses to leave your very person void and many copied. Throughout the years, I just sat back and observed my droids I execute. All of these whack motherfuckers that get the boot question, dude. How the fuck you look like Snake Eyes and dress like Duke?
Yo, never mind.
You don't know that shit, never mind. I do music. Played many events with crews. Many came in attendance too, I even pretended to. Be cool with performing at Dirtbag's fundraiser show to help them get to you. You're welcome. Cause by Muda being in the building that night, at least put 100 on the flight. I know here it don't mean nothing, but where you at? You a millionaire motherfucker for the night, let's be honest. Yo, you always acting all desperado knowing you would never shoot me. You probably rather much read 220 books for a message and teach a lesson to me. Tell me this, why you have thousands upon thousands of people at your events for viewing and none of them motherfuckers want to cheer for anyone else except for Looney? Yo, it's true, be up. Oh, don't get mad to me, okay? I have the Prius style. You don't have a chance. You should have saved gas, you know, like a Prius style. I'm sorry, my English is false. I don't speak in crowds, but I promise, as soon as I'm graduation from school, I'll invite you all to eat my house. Ano? Galit ka ba? Oh. Abay, gago ka pala. Tangina mo, sarap mo sampalin at sakalin sa panga. You're the wrong guy for your barangay, tol. Lahat yung mga nakatanbay, magtagay ng tanduay kasi patay na to. You're the wrong guy for your barangay, tol. Lahat yung mga nakatanbay, magtagay ng tanduay kasi patay na to. Y'all don't feel that? It's all good, because I don't need to win. Those bars were for y'all motherfuckers. Those were just between me and him. You ain't never faced any struggle, but you slap yourself in the face couple times, get your head in the game, do a huddle. Anybody famous and Asian that hustles, I'll tell you Fredo is trouble, and might be the best flip you ever heard. That, my friend, is the greatest rebuttal. Let's go!